Hello viewers, welcome back to Lucy's channel. We're going to do a reading here today, but just thought I would let Lucy sit here and be admired for a few minutes. You guys haven't seen her in a video in a little while. We had really bad storms here yesterday on Sunday, and my power keeps going out, so I thought, you know what, my power's back up, let's take a minute and do a reading. I want to do a reading on, is Putin done with Trump? I kind of want to look at how his energy is going in regards to Trump. What's he feeling? What's his plans? We know they're going to keep meddling in the U.S. elections going into 2020, but just want to see what's he feeling about Trump right now. And Lucy's going to lay on the table, so we're going to have to either move her in a minute here or lay the cards around her big furry butt. She's got a very fluffy back end. And once again, there's cat fur all over the table. It's been storming so much, and these sudden storms that come up, I haven't even been able to get Lucy outside in the garden to do any updated videos, so. The star cards, he still has hope for Trump. Hope that he'll do something for him. Let's see. Lucy's tail swishing everywhere. Well, we've got Putin here, end of a cycle, beginning something new, and this is a success and victory card. So he feels victorious with Trump. He got him in there. But his challenge is to keep working with him in the same way. So he knows the moneyed news is coming in here in the past, that things are starting to come in. And at the root of this, you know, to the government, that the government is getting the moneyed information. It's crowning the reading. I feel like he knows that Trump is going to walk away eventually from his position, so things are a little bit erratic here in the future. He's not working with him consistently is what I'm getting. He's being a little erratic with him because Trump is being erratic. And here we have the Fool clarifying that, and justice coming down for him, and new plans, new beginnings, charging in with some new plans. So it feels like he's trying to give advice to Trump. You know, it feels like too with Don Jr., Trump, you know, and the oligarchs, he's trying to give advice to them about their thievery and, you know, the emissaries of the money that, you know, it's coming out that where the money came from. Yeah, the spy card here and being separated from Trump because of that. So let's take a look. I want to ask, you know, when the first people that came into the White House to visit Trump day one of his presidency were Russians, the Russian ambassador and oligarchs and different people. I want to see, did they bug the White House? Did they wiretap the White House so that they could keep up with what Trump was doing. Although I feel like Trump just picks up the phone and calls him whenever he wants to talk to him. And Putin just picks up the phone and calls him also. I want to see if they wiretap to bug the Oval Office. Yeah, this is the winning at any cost. It's winning with dishonor. You know, there's no honor in the win. Stealing the election. Lucy in her tail, swishing my cards around. So, emotional news coming to Putin. Emotional news. And the challenge is that he's battle weary. So, he's getting emotional news from the White House. So, you know, in regards to Russia here in the past and being tied to the devil and all the greed and avarice. But there's emotional news coming because of investigators. And, you know, this is about charging forward with a plan, too. So, I feel like he did have plans, you know, for the White House, but I'm not getting communication cards. He's getting emotional news. But it's probably more in tweets and phone calls. I don't feel like if I saw a bunch of wands, I would say, yeah, he wiretapped the Oval Office. But, you know, time's up here for Russia. All the illusions coming out here and sort of truth. End of a cycle. Big changes. Secrets coming out on the GOP, so not just on the White House, but also how Russia worked with the GOP. So I don't feel like he wiretapped anything, but I do feel like he had other contacts also within the GOP that he was talking with. So it feels like a fluid communication was there, but not through wiretapping. Just thought I would ask. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, interesting, Mother Russia still on the bottom. Thanks for watching. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe to see future videos.